Hello guys, Garcia here. Welcome back to Anti-Tribute. So today guys, we'll finally be getting our gargoyle. So I was troubleshooting all day today, and I actually had to watch a couple of playthroughs of this quest to understand what I was missing. And it turns out I was missing literally just a piece of paper. So it was literally just a missing piece. So we'll finally be getting our gargoyle today. In relation to the Romero quest, we'll try it again today, and if it doesn't work, we'll just leave it. I'm not sure exactly how I would like circumvent that bug, that crash that we are having. Not crash, I'm getting stuck in place. So we'll see. So finally we can do all of that. But first of all, let's talk to Strauss here because we completed the gargoyle quest. So let's get the reward.
Hello, Neonate.
Of course. So I resolved the issue with the gargoyle.
You did. That's quite an accomplishment for one so young, Neonate. And with discretion as well. Again, you impress me.
Oh, thank you.
And your efforts are well appreciated. Please accept this gift as payment for your accomplishment. The Tremere clan appreciates your confidentiality.
Oh, I'm sure. Oh, 500. My God. I'm sure the Tremere clan does, not you. So yeah, 500 is a lot for this quest. So since we are going to get the gargoyle, I'm going to send Nox back home, to be honest. I could send him back to like the asylum, but I'm afraid that we'll bug out something. So I'm just going to send him back to the Haven for now. So yeah, it was a very frustrating process trying to troubleshoot what was going wrong with the quest. I thought I broke the quest because I already have all the pieces that we need. Basically, we needed the amulet, the talisman. We needed the werewolf blood, and we also needed the thaumaturgical creatures book here, and we have all of them. So I thought that maybe I got the items before I reached the point, in the quest that I should actually have them, you know. So maybe basically it would be like a time issue. So at a certain stage of the quest, you are not allowed to have a certain item, and I had it, and I thought that like broke the quest. So it was like a timing situation, but I found out that that's not the case, so we'll just go and fix it. But
Master,
you go home, sir. Stop traveling with me. There you go. I don't know if he went home. Hopefully yes. So it's just me and Utoret for a while. So these are the only two holdups that we had. We had to solve the gargoyle situation, and we also had to try the Romero quest again, so we'll do both of those today. And basically we have a clean slate, and we'll start doing quests that I didn't do in my other playthroughs. So I'm going to show you guys exactly what happened with the quest and why I was having trouble. So if you guys want to play Anti-Tribute eventually, you guys will know what to do. So it wasn't a bug at all. I just literally didn't click on a piece of paper, and that like didn't continue the quest chain for me. So it was basically my mistake, like a clerical error, so to speak. So let's go. I'm trying to remember if the other Romero quests also gives me like some decent rewards. I think he just gives you some money, and like you get one XP point or maybe two in the base game. That one quest, like Pimping for Romero, if you guys remember that quest. Actually, you know what?
Do anything with
wait here. Walking around with her is terrible here. Alright, so you guys, if you guys remember, the first thing that we did for this quest, we actually checked the email here for Gimbal. And then we found out that he actually had some sort of creature down there. Because they intercepted a package that was going for the Club Confession, I think. So, I went down here, right? And then I just did the Gimbal quest as normal. So I defeated Gimbal. Then I checked the emails, and I checked the rest of the emails on the PC. And we went here, and we saw the gargoyle here. And then that's about it, right? So I'm stuck in this part of the quest. So I have all the items that I need, as I just told you guys. And my quest is stuck on this section right here. I think the statue, which looks like a dead vampire body, could serve as a resource for the creation of a gargoyle. I need to search for more information. So I'm stuck in that part. So I have everything, but I wasn't able to progress on the quest. So what I should have done is, you leave here after fighting Gimbal, or basically after checking the emails on the computer, then you enter here, and here there's a paper. So, experiment number 29. So I tried all kinds of blood that I had on this statue, but without results. I need stronger blood, so this is probably Gimbal, right? In a certain treatise, it was written that werewolf blood may be worth trying. There are rumors of some that some of it is in Santa Monica Hospital right now. Also, I continue to watch the Tremere Chantry downtown. It should contain useful things in that regard. There you go. So find the quest moved, as you can see. Now I need werewolf blood. You seriously think that there is some in Santa Monica Clinic? Actually, there was. It might also be worth visiting the Tremere Chantry downtown. There you go. So find that the quest is starting to move here slowly. So you might think, whoa, but you already have the werewolf blood. What should you do now? Well, you guys will see. So it turns out I was remembering bits and pieces of the quest, but not the entire picture, you know? Well, she's going to show up here anyway. So now that I understand the entire sequence of events here, it makes more sense. So basically, the whole problem that we were having with this quest was because I didn't check that particular piece of paper. That's it. Now we can totally do the quest. Actually, I need to feed a little bit, but... yeah, I think it's a bit too early for Dr. Malcolm here. So let's just keep going. In the beginning, when I noticed what I did wrong, I was so mad because, like, oh man, I wasted my time. I wasted everybody's time. But then I was like, well, at least I can continue doing what I was doing. And my mouse just died. So guys, just wait just a second. I will reconnect my mouse here and we'll continue with in a moment. Hey guys, I'm back. So I just reconnected the mouse. So let's continue here. I don't know why I disconnected, by the way. All right, so let's just go. So now that we have all the info that we needed, we can go to the chantry. So if you guys remember, I thought an object was missing from the table in that room that we need the code to open. You guys will see. It turns out it was not what I thought that it was missing there. I thought there was a PC there because some mods have PCs in that room. I don't remember if the vanilla game has a PC there. So that's what I thought the place was missing. And then I thought, oh, maybe that was replaced by the PC on the Tremere Haven, right? So this door up here. So that PC should be the one replacing this one, right? Wrong.
No one again.
I needed to continue the quest here. Get behind me. So then eventually this is going to show up here. A telephone.
If you want to learn more about gargoyles, check confession card.
Okay. There you go. So our second update. So what the hell is going on? Someone asked me to check the club confession. So... what I was missing here was actually the telephone. And that's why I wasn't seeing it. It's because I just didn't progress enough in the quest. Picked the wrong side. So now, I finally can continue with the quest. So I remembered like the part at the confession. I remember that there's a part in the Empire Arms Hotel. I remember several parts, but I didn't remember the order. And... because of that damn piece of like a diary that we had to check out at Gimbal's place, nothing was working. So now we'll be able to do all the parts that we need. It's actually quite a short quest line, all things considered. So after we finish, we'll go through it again. So you guys, if you want to play Anti-Tribute and you want to get the gargoyle, you guys will know all the steps. Oh, sorry. I need to go to the confession first. Oh, that's going to actually be a problem now that I think of it. You guys will see. So if you remember, the statue was originally going to be sent to the confession to become like a decoration. Come here.
No, don't.
Stay here? Or not?
Come Master. Here.
Get behind? Okay. I need to actually break this. But if I break, she might become hostile here and start killing people. That's not going to be great. I hope I can break this without too much problem. Okay, I need to read something that's inside here. Where is it? Well, here it is. So, hey newbie, do you got the thaumaturgical creatures? Now, besides this book and the blood, you need another item. The Tremere Regent has it. You can get it from him diplomatically or by force. Oh yes, you need to make a ritual. I recommend the backstage room of the Empire Hotel. Be careful, newbie. You are not the only one looking for this knowledge. There you go. So now we need to go to the Empire Arms. There you go, our next update. Luckily, she didn't attack anybody there. Okay. Need the werewolf blood, the book, and the thing from the regent. So this thing from the regent, I'm going to explain here. So if you guys remember, at the Chantry, there's a fireplace. The fireplace in that when you first meet Strauss, he's right in the front of, basically. So the fireplace is right behind him. In that fireplace, there's a gargoyle on top of it. And there's like a compartment that you can open. It's basically one of those things that you can... Jesus, I forgot the name of the object that locks stuff. Damn it. What's the name of that in English? I forgot. But basically you can interact with that statue. And there you can find werewolf blood, another one, and you can also find the amulet. So you do not need to do the gargoyle quest and get the amulet straight from Strauss in Hollywood. You can do this before. You can do it by just reaching this point on the quest, and then you go to the Chantry, you interact with the gargoyle on top of the fireplace, and then you can get one more werewolf blood, so you don't even need the blood that I got from the Tremere Haven, which is also at Strauss's place. And you also don't need the talisman that he's going to give you for the gargoyle quest, you know? So you can do this earlier. Now I know that, but it's too late. Damn, I forgot the name of the thing in English. The padlock. That's right. When you interact with something, and instead of this, you get a padlock. You get that from that gargoyle on top of the fireplace for that is on Strauss's place there. And there you can get the two pieces that you need. And the book is also there, so you get the book there, then you basically can get all the pieces there. So as you saw there, there was a small cutscene here. Just stay here, Jeanette.
No, oh, Tourette, sorry. Play.
Stay here. Okay. Man, that was killing me, forgetting the name of the thing. I think it's padlock. And do you guys know how do I know that that is called a padlock in English? Granny. Do you know the Granny games? Granny's awesome. And Granny has a... I think all of the Granny games, 1, 2, and 3, have the padlock key, which is an item that you can get to open one of the escapes, one of the endings of the game. So good old Granny saving the day again. So there you go. Oh. So this is just an object. Bye. I already got the ring here earlier. So I need to interact with this. So it's an excerpt from Bestiaire d'Amour, Bestiary of Love by Richard de Fournival, 1245. Oh, that's very old. Amiens, France. So, in order to revive the sculpture to create the gargoyle, one needs to sprinkle the stone with the most powerful blood that can be found, werewolf blood. One needs to place the magical manuscript with knowledge about gargoyles on the altar, the book. And one needs to place the amulet with the same substance that once already produced a gargoyle into the magical manuscript on the altar. So, the talisman. So, translation by Jeanette Beer. Beer? Really? Jeanette. University of California Press, 1986. If that was actual Jeanette. Oh, Jesus! What the fuck?
Police!
What the fuck? Is this. Oh! Actual cops? What the hell? That's crazy. Why cops? Of all people. I would expect like the Sabbat here. Not cops. But okay. At least the cop in the entrance here didn't react. So yeah, that's basically the quest is done. We just need to go to Santa Monica now. So as you can see, super simple. I just skipped a step, basically. By complete like ineptitude. I just didn't check that room because I wasn't expecting to see anything there. Do you guys remember when I explored the Gimbal's place? Like the first episode? I opened the chest because I remember that there was an extra chest there. But I did not explore the other rooms because I didn't think that... Actually, that was the only room I didn't explore. Because the other room had the body of an alien creature. Which is very similar to the actual gargoyle we're going to get. So the only room I didn't open was the room I needed to open, you know?
I like to bite.
Oh, chill, bro. Chill. We're good. Okay. Man, the cop is like right here. And there's blood here too. What the hell? Must be of like one of our encounters with the hunter. Or one of the hunters, I guess. Okay. Now that I know that we can get the gargoyle, that's kind of saved the playthrough for me. Because I was thinking, if I can't do that, I'll have to come back here and post a video like, I'll have to restart. And I will have to replay the entire mod once again to do the correct steps. And maybe if it was still broken, maybe it was like would be like unfixable. Because the main thing about this mod that is new is the gargoyle quest. Some of the I think you can get different endings in a couple of other main quests. But the main thing is to like having the gargoyle fight for you. And man, if that failed, I would have to either try from the beginning or just finish the mod without getting the gargoyle. Which would not be cool. So, don't forget, there it is. I need to wait for Tourette to arrive here, because I need to ask her to wait. Otherwise, she's going to get stuck in that room there. Where is she? Oh. Come on. Tourette. Thank you.
Do any...
stay here. We're not going to use Tourette for like too long. Because if you guys remember, I want to get Vivi. We'll probably get Vivi in this episode. My guess is that Vivi was better, because I remember using Vivi before in this mod. But maybe I just got Vivi because I liked her more, I don't know. We'll see. So as you can see, now I can interact with it. So here, we probably should drop the werewolf blood, right? Oh, okay. It's up. There you go. Now... I need the book, right? The book. There you go. Alright. What now? Oh, I need to put a talisman. I see. There you go. Oh! It's alive! So listen to me carefully. You're a gargoyle, I am your master, I created you. I will call you Rockbiter. Really? That's a lame name. Now and forever, you will be known by that name. That's one hell of a punishment. So for now, you will serve me until I set you free. There you go. It's done. Follow me. First, let's try to possess this guy, just to see what the hell he has here. Oh, I possessed the wrong one. what is F5? F6? That's Tourette. F7. There you go. So let's see. Oh man, that's crazy. So as you guys can see, he's extremely strong. He's a brawler, basically. He doesn't have any sort of like knowledges or anything like that. It's just a piece of stone that fights, basically. Tons of stamina. So yeah, he can resist a lot during the fights here. 4 potence, 3 obfuscate, and 2 celerity. This guy's just a killing machine. His stealth is really high too, which is great. Yeah, this guy's amazing. He's very worth it, I would say. Really worth it, that's what I meant to say. Rock Biter, my man. Alright, so let's go back to my main guy here. So, the most important... actually, I need to talk to him to fight with his fists. So, always fight hand to hand. There you go. Now, the biggest problem that we might have here is the Masquerade. I don't know if I can walk around with this guy or if I can only use him in like quests that are not related to cities. So I can use him without breaking the masquerade. I'm not sure.
No any game.
Come with me. So you know what? Let's just test it. Let's walk around Santa Monica a little bit. So that's it, guys. So recap. You check the PC. You get the info that the crate that was going to France was intercepted and is here in the basement of Gimbal's prosthetics. And Gimbal is working for someone, I don't know who that is. So he's probably a ghoul or something. Then you come down here, even before the fight with Gimbal, you enter here and you click here. So this will send you to the Chantry. Oh, I shouldn't have clicked this. There you go, that was a mistake. And then after this you go to the Chantry, you see the telephone. While in the Chantry you can already get the book, right? And then after that, with that that phone is going to send you to the Club Confession. You go to the club, you break the boxes. Inside the box there's going to be a piece of paper. You read the paper. That's going to send you to the Empire Arms Hotel. You go to the backstage area, you get the excerpt from the actual book from the guy that created the gargoyle creating process. And with that, you will know every single thing that you need. Werewolf Blood, you can get one in the quest for LaCroix at Santa Monica. You can get one in the Haven of the Tremieres in the Strauss place there. I forgot the name of the place, the Chantry. And you can get another one from that statue on top of the fireplace. You can get a talisman and you can get the werewolf blood there. But you need to be in a certain point of the quest to do that. So you can actually get the gargoyle very earlier. very early and way earlier than what I'm doing here. Just because I didn't follow the quest properly. So I don't think you don't even really need to go to Hollywood. You can get it in downtown already. So as you can see, it was just a big mistake that I made here. But that's it. So if you guys want to get the gargoyle while playing Anti-Tribute, that's what you do. Okay, so I'll have to load here, unfortunately. Because I got the quest again. I don't want this quest forever in my quest log here. So I have to do some things again here, but I don't think it's going to be a lot. All right, so we just did the Empire Arms Hotel thing in this park, right? Yeah, we just need to go to Santa Monica real quick. So I apologize for that. I didn't know that I would get the quest again. But yeah, now we know. So there you go, another good piece of knowledge you have. Don't click on anything related to the quest after you finish the quest. Otherwise, you are going to restart the cycle of the quest. And no, I don't think you can get two gargoyles, I'm pretty sure. But hey, you know what? Actually, I'm not sure about that.
Hop in.
Maybe it's possible. That would actually be funny. Walking around with two gargoyles. Actually, that would not be good, now that I think about it. Because they are extremely strong. They are probably the best partners you can possibly have here.
Here, kitty, 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 kitty.
But the thing with the gargoyles is that they are basically melee only companions, right? So if you need someone to help you shoot stuff, like when you fight the guy that the Magilla Gorilla, the guy that walks around with LaCroix, I forgot the name of, that they call him. The sheriff, there you go. So for example, when you are going to fight the sheriff or Ming Zhao, for example, you would want you would want a couple of followers that can actually shoot. So I don't think having two gargoyles would be great actually. But I could be wrong, obviously. So outside of this and the VV quests, I have no idea about anything else that this mod gives you, or any new quests or anything like that. So we are going to find out together. At least everybody together, us and the gargoyle here. So I'm glad that the main point of the mod, we were able to actually do it. Or reach it. Okay, so let's go again. Where's the blood? Here. Book. Other one. Okay. The entire time when I first played this mod, I thought that the Animus would be the thing, that I need to do something with the Animus to actually get the gargoyle. Turns out the Animus is completely unrelated. Listen, gargoyle, rock ladder, follow me. Okay, we're done. So finally, let's actually test the gargoyle here. I hope he doesn't like start attacking random passers here. Just, you know, oh, like he's hungry or something like that. I find it hard to believe that a gargoyle would eat, especially made out of stone. But hey, this is a game, so who knows. Alright, so please don't break the masquerade instantly, because then that would limit how we would be able to use the gargoyle. Let's walk around here. There's a cop. Come on, gargoyle. So apparently he's not like Nosferatu. I don't think he's going to make us break the masquerade on sight. But I also don't know where he is either. He vanished. But that's not something that happens only to him. All the companions vanish every little while. Okay, so I'm going to enter here just to feed on Dr. Malcolm. I hope the gargoyle doesn't kill him. But who knows, to be honest. Yeah, so the gargoyle is in the middle of everything here and no one's reacting. I think it's fine. That would be like the biggest problem, in my opinion. Because then you would only be able to do instance content with them. So for example, if you go like to the Society of Leopold or something, but if you do anything related to walking around in a hub, he would be just terrible. Well, we had a slow down there for some reason. I don't know what happened. Okay. Alright, so now that we did that, we can proceed with the game. So, actually, the first thing that we are going to do, we are going to try the
Master
Romero quest again. Stop traveling with me, return to the Haven. I'm curious to see where this guy will be on the Haven. Which position? He's the number 3, right? The third follower that I got. Alright. So let's go. Let's try to do the Romero quest again. If it doesn't work, fuck it. And we'll move on without it. The one that we really needed to work at least like have a shot in this mod was this one. The gargoyle one. So now that this one is done, I feel way better about it. But man, oh, no joke. 3-4 hours today researching this stuff. The main problem is that there was a lot of information about Anti-Tribute. It's a super easy information to find if the original Planet Vampire was up. But if you guys remember, we lost the forum and we lost the second one too. So we only have the newer one. And the newer one only has information about mods that are either popular right now, in terms of like people are still playing and still finding bugs for them. War Games is a great example of this. Or mods that are always being like updated, like the unofficial patch and stuff, you know? So everything related to Anti-Tribute was lost to time. Anti-Tribute actually had a site dedicated just to Anti-Tribute, but most of its features are down, and basically the site kind of doesn't exist, just a skeleton of what it used to be. So I had to watch playthroughs to actually know what to do, you know? It was kind of annoying, but hey, it's done. Alright, so let's see.
Oh, there, Slick.
Hey, Slick.
I want to think about... Who else? Name's Romero.
Romero.
See, it's... Dilly figured out. Sure thumb. Who knows? You're telling me. I love... Hey.
Sure.
I'll be back. No. Fant.
Alright, got it. Okay, so right about now, I should be able to move. And yeah, I'm still stuck. Cannot move. I can't open my thing here. But that's about it. The only thing that I could do here, I tried already, which is the no-clip thing. I don't think in the console you can like teleport to different places. The console of this game is not as well developed as like Oblivion's is, for example. Where like you can complete any quest and get any item and things of that nature. The commands are a little bit more specific. So yeah, I can't move, I can't do anything, so let's just skip Romero. Actually, we could go back to Santa Monica. Not sure. So there you go, guys. I tried the Romero thing. It's just not working. I don't know. I thought the problem with the Romero quest was that I had already broken the Gargoyle quest. So I thought that was like... I was having like a cascade effect, you know? I was like, oh, I broke this one, and then this one broke part of that one, and I thought the entire rest of the playthrough would be like a mess. But it turns out it's only this one. So I don't know what's happening there. I never had this bug here before, not even in the vanilla one, so I can't troubleshoot what I don't know. That's why I was having so much trouble with the Gargoyle quest. I didn't know what went wrong.
Where to?
Alright, so let's go back to the Haven, let's get the guys real quick, and we will proceed here. So we cannot do the Romero quest. We have the quest for the Lucky Star, but we have another quest that will send us there, so I'm waiting for that quest. We also have the quest for Vivi, and we have the quest for Ash Rivers. That quest that is going to send us to the Sin Bin, we already got to. It's part of the main quest of Hollywood. Abrams gave that quest to us. So yeah, that's what I remember here. But damn, the Romero thing is kind of annoying. I don't like that quest at all. I never, not even once, completed that quest normally. I always cheesed that quest. I always, like, started hiding at the first minute and completed it eventually. I never like defended the gates, which is the point of the quest. It's just a terrible quest. Horribly designed, in my opinion. It is possible, but it's very annoying. It's just not worth it, because the other method gives you the same XP, you know? So why do that? Oh, there he is, as you can see. So I'm gonna get my guys here, but first let me just check the PC real quick. We have nothing. Not popular enough, I guess. Alright, so let me drop some things here. Here. I'll keep this. Drop this here. Everything that can sell. Oh, morphine bottle, I cannot drop here anymore. I already have the maximum amount. Okay. So I don't think I need anything else. That's the security book, investigation book that I'm not going to use. The sword's still here. Everything's fine. Okay. So you stay here. This is your new life? Oh, let's talk to good old Heather.
Oh, you're back. I went out this evening and I met someone and he wouldn't leave me alone, so he came back here with me and, well, I thought you might want to drink his blood.
Oh, I see. Thank you.
I'm just glad you're pleased. He's in the bathroom. Don't worry, I locked him in.
Oh, thank you. Oh, if I knew that, I wouldn't have fed on good old Malcolm. But I didn't know we were at that point, so... Oh, a cop? My god. Alright, not going to waste time talking to this guy, I'm just going to feed.
Need
so, Jesus.
You never sleep at night. I
okay, so
you
stay
sleep,
there?
Right?
I sleep at work.
And what exactly do you do?
I'm a middle school teacher.
Okay. Now, let's go.
No one eat games with
travel with me. And you too, sir. Travel with me.
Let's see who else we got.
Okay. Tourette, please.
It's you.
Oh, I need to tell her to stay inside, right? Leave my service? No. So it wasn't me. It could be one of a number of people who want me deader.
Want you dead?
Heather promised me to stay indoors until this is over. There you go. Option 3.
I will.
There you go. So she's going to be fine. Hopefully. Which is weird because in this particular mod with the companion mod, we have so many companions that it seems like kind of a futile exercise here to even like try to keep her alive. That said, I don't like getting her killed, so you know, I'll just do it. The Heather thing to me is like the hacking thing. Like, I know the passwords, I don't need to put points in hacking, but I always put points in hacking, always. I've never played a game where I was like, oh, I know the passwords, I don't need to, you know, spend points on this. Never done that once. Completely breaks the immersion for me, to be honest. Okay, so the first one that we're going to do, let's try to do the Ash Rivers quest first. Because that one is disconnected from everything else. And by the way, I'm pretty sure you can get Ash Rivers as a companion too. Problem with Ash is that he sucks, right? He's not like a super old vampire, so I don't think he's going to be good for us anyway. Little asshole. So let me see what else we need to do here. Well, these are on the Lucky Star. This one's on the Giovanni Mansion. We're way too far away from that. Snuff film? Sure. So yeah, we don't have really anything else going on for us. Oh, this guy looks very dangerous. Luckily, I can't jump the tables here. Looking for items. Oh, there he is. Oh, very sneaky. Do we have new NPCs here? No, just... Oh, the guy from one of the solutions of the quest. Betty. I sent her to San Diego, she's in freaking Hollywood. What the hell, Patty? Hey, Ash.
I just met. Why don't you ask everyone else? Ash. Son's... Never mind. We need... What's the... To say it, you didn't.
The hunters.
Fine, back. I could just. Hey, did Isaac? What the heck?
Money.
Fine, I've got chores up.
From the sewers?
Sure about that?
Yeah?
I don't know that you even out the odds a whole lot.
Maybe I don't. Maybe I don't even out the odds a lot. But my friend, I have a gargoyle to sell you. You have no idea. So, I think we should just go guns blazing because we have the gargoyle here. So the more we can get him to attack the enemies, the better for us. Well, we don't have a choice anymore. Where's the gargoyle? Maybe he vanished already? Oh, Ash actually has a health bar here. Come on. Oh! There's so many enemies here, we are actually having slowdowns just because of the amount. That's great. Yeah, the gargoyle is not even showing up. Be honest. Oh! This guy has the Ultra Hunter. Oh, that's great. He has that skill from Grunfeld Bach. Yeah, the cross. The Ultra Hunter. Awesome. Oh. Cool, we got extra speed. Jesus, I'm taking so much damage here. Come on, Gargoyle. Are you going to attack her now? Well? Oh, damn it. Well, the Gargoyle is not doing anything at all. So far. Hopefully on the bosses he's going to help, but right now he's just a zero. Well, that's a lie, at least he's eating some shots for us.
Yeah.
I have to just feed on this guy a little bit, or not. Damn it, taking so much damage here. Yeah, bringing the gargoyle here clearly was a mistake. He's just kind of there. I'm in a lot of trouble here. At least the potence is just doing so much damage. I'm killing everybody real quick here. But that said, I basically don't have blood anymore. I really need to feed here. Otherwise, I'm screwed. Oh yeah, I have the... I forgot. I have the chalice. Alright, that saved everything. Okay. Awesome. Come on, I know I can hit you. There you go. Oh, that was very close. Okay, so I don't know if the gargoyle is kind of bugged, if the fact that I talked to him about combat made him bug out or something. We have to troubleshoot that, because I need this guy to work. I mean, I don't need it. I can just walk around with Tourette and VV and be fine, I think. Oh, he actually used a discipline. Never seen that before. Negative zero? Huh. Should I get this guy? Just for the laws? You know what? You don't have to leave. You could travel with me, join my group.
The only group I belong to is the Actors Union. I avoid all that clan crap.
Oh. Join my team and you will be safe.
I didn't ask for this. I didn't ask Isaac to save my life. Maybe I wanted to die. I was having fun, damn it. I was alive.
Alright. So if you want to leave again, have fun again, then listen to my proposal.
Whatever.
So, what you need is a purpose, a cause worth fighting for.
Yeah.
Follow me and I'll give you a purpose.
What's the catch?
All my followers must drink the blood of this creature.
What?
Bottoms up. There you go. Let the fire consume you. Let your mind become mine. Now lead me out of here. There you go. So we got Ash. But I don't know if he's going to be here because I have three companions right now. You cannot have three. So one of them must go away. Yeah, as I thought. So he's probably in our haven. So we'll go there, check him out. Oh. I don't know what's up with the gargoyle, by the way. I don't know what happened, why he's not fighting. Maybe it was just on that quest, who knows. Let's talk about combat. I'm going to click again. Always fight hand to hand. Option 2. I'm pretty sure I didn't click the wrong option before, so I'm not sure exactly what happened there. Ash Rivers, huh? It would be funny if he's actually strong. The only thing that I know about her is that he has celerity, because we saw it. That's about it. We'll see. And also, I did notice the quest gave us 6 points. That's crazy. So hopefully, eventually, we'll be able to start putting some points in Obtenebration. The problem with that one is that, obviously, it's another discipline, which means that it's going to be very, very, very expensive. So I can only spend points on it if I am like 100% sure that I'm not going to need those points.
Hop in.
And that's actually not easy to do. Unfortunately, I need to go to downtown to go to the Haven, because in this mod, the Haven in Santa Monica doesn't work anymore. Oh, now he's fighting for some reason. Let's just answer stealth because they will de-aggro. Yeah, we're fine. Actually, you know what? We should go to the Haven, the Tremere Haven. Because Heather is there all the time, so maybe Ash Rivers is there too. We'll see. Obviously, I never got Ash before because I've never done this quest in this mod before. But I knew he was one of the companions because I remember reading a list of guys that you could get way back in the day. So I was very curious. Oh, up here? Oh, damn. Yeah. You have to be very careful with the direction you move in this mod.
No one ate game.
You get stuck all the damn time. She's here? What about Ash? Is he here? No, the guy from the bathroom? So yeah, we have to go to the actual Haven. Man, so much time wasted. Just like little things that could be like completely fixable, I think. Or completely fixed. Just to make things go faster. That said, the actual gargoyle quest turned out to be very simple. After I understood like what was wrong with it. So I can't complain too much. Okay. Empire. So yeah, I discovered that this thing here, the TV here, is actually always here. It's not a sign of like playing too long. So for some reason there's this TV there. I don't know if in the vanilla version that the TV is also there. Maybe. I don't remember. I don't pay attention to that too much. I hope they don't, like, create a logjam here. Sometimes they get stuck in the process here of moving. And literally you cannot move the elevator anymore because they, like, physically forbid you from moving. Yeah, I think that just happened right now. As you can see, it never stops going up. Now we're stuck. Let me see if I can go back. No. Stuck. So there you go. So that's why I don't like companion mod. I said that like in the first episode, literally. Actually, I said that during the War Games playthrough too. The one mod that's very popular for this game that I don't like. Not because of the mod, but because of how it's implemented. I actually don't even remember what we were doing. Oh, I see. I was like, why was I in the Chantry? And yeah, we are having this like small jumps here on the game here. It's not even like a slowdown, it's just like a little freeze. Every time that the gargoyle is too far away and he teleports, it freezes the screen for like a second, you know? It's happening every time. We can replicate it. But I don't think he's going to teleport this time. There you go. So it kind of freezes the screen every time. So if this guy keeps freezing the screen and he keeps not fighting, I'll just let him be, you know? I need him to fight to be useful. Alright, so stay here. Tourette, where are you?
Do any...
Also stay here. Okay, let's save again. The elevator of doom here. I actually have a very funny story with elevators in games. The game that I played the most in my life by a gigantic margin, like almost 5,000 hours, is World of Warcraft. In World of Warcraft, all the big raids in the game have elevators to access the different... Why are you guys here? To access the different floors.
No any game.
So we had a thing in the game called the elevator boss. So basically every time someone died because they fell off the elevator and got crushed by it, we would call, oh, that's one more kill for the elevator boss, you know? So every time I see an elevator in life, I think I'm gonna fall from it. Not be crushed by it and not the elevator is going to fall. I'm going to literally like pass through the elevator, you know? I'm trying to see where Ash Rivers here is.
You have nightmares about them.
Yeah, that's not normal. I know. Okay. Yeah, the gargoyle is not helping right now. Come on, guys. I asked you guys so like kindly to wake me downstairs. Oh, now I need to.
No,
I need to move. I need to move. Yeah, so I don't know what Ash is. Apparently I got him, but not really. Okay, whatever. Eventually, maybe in the next time I load, he's going to show up here. Because obviously the chair is already here and so on and so on. So maybe he fell through the world here. But you know what? Whatever. Let's just go. My god, Gargoyle, please. If we get Vivi... and the gargoyle never helps, I'll just get her and use her, to be honest.
Master.
Oh, sorry. That's not what I wanted to do.
No any.
There you go. So yeah, these companions can be very annoying. Because you have to remember, this game was never made with companions in mind at all. I do remember that early in development, they thought about either like a multiplayer type situation or you can walk around with your ghouls and stuff, but that never like materialized in the main game alongside a bunch of other things that never were materialized. And oh, I thought that was a crash, to be honest. Nope. Okay, so let's go back to Hollywood now. Well, let me feed real quick here. This guy's perfect spot in the shadow. Yes, so... Oh, Jesus. The cell phone just bugged out completely.
Hey, stop right there.
No, don't do that.
I like to fight.
Why? Alright, that's not my problem. Let's just go.
Stop right there!
Oh, Jesus. This companion sometimes. Let me tell you. So as I told you guys, sometimes they just decide to act by themselves. Now I need to wait because I can't talk during combat here.
Hey, who's there?
All right, now I can. Oh, I cannot. Police is hunting. I need to wait now. Yeah, the gargoyle is making everything slow down here, to be honest. But we still haven't had the opportunity to actually test him. He probably is going to be very good in any instanced quest. So when we have a quest that does not involve like walking around the city, we actually know how good he is. That's the funny part. We did all of this for the gargoyle. I have no idea if he's good or not. Because in my other playthrough, I never used him for anything. I just completed the quest and I stopped right there.
Going somewhere.
So I'm not sure if he's actually good or not. The stats are good, you know what I mean? But who knows? Oh no, already? Causing trouble. Yeah, but I still don't have any extra masquerade violations here. Alright, so let's go to Vesuvius here. The next group of quests that we need to do. Hopefully we can get V here. How do I convince V to drink this? That's the question. I have no idea. She's very savvy. I don't think this mod is going to have extra items here. Let's check, just in case. Yeah. Hey, miss. Who are you? Sure. Lead away. I like the fact that they randomly use discipline too. Why would you use a discipline in the open like that? Sure.
The reason I have
I appreciate it.
Think nothing, I'm velvet. Below. Call me velvet.
Sure.
It's been months since I've seen.
What should I ask?
I'm like a...
Tell me about your hunter problem.
Hunters. Yes.
Okay.
For a few weeks, one of them was worth it.
Alright, maybe I could take care of her.
Which you?
Thank you.
She works over. I want you to.
Simbin, sure. Be back in a minute. Alright, this quest, as you guys know, has a catch, actually. Which is, we need to kill the huntress here without making too much noise. Which usually means without gunfire. That obviously is a problem because we have Jeanette here, Tourette here. And she obviously fights with ranged weapons. So, Jesus. Damn gargoyle. So this is going to be a good opportunity to test the gargoyle. This is exactly the type of quest that he would help. So I'm going to ask for Jeanette to wait here. Tourette. Jesus. I always call her just Jeanette because that's her face here. Stay here. Oh, so this is the song of the Simbin now.
Hey,
I see.
Slick.
Hey, man. Tell me about your place.
Man, we got everything you left.
All right.
Yeah.
Death Mask Productions.
Real. All right. The kind of real enough.
Okay.
A tape. Look, man.
All right.
Forget it, man. Okay. And then all you have.
There you go. So that quest completed.
Hey, wait.
Okay, so now let's go for the second one. You got a girl who works here with a broken heart tattoo on her back?
Yeah, Chastity. She worked. Alright.
Alright, there you go. Man, she's just following me around. Just asked her to stay. Alright, stay again, please. Don't move around. I need you to stay here. It's just not working. She's just following me everywhere. You know what? I think I'm going to send her home. That guarantees that she's not going to bother us here. Okay, see? Alright. Now we'll see if the gargoyle actually helps. How much do I need? 6. I have 6. $150, okay. Let's open this one too. Oh, a book? The Art of Horror. Sure. 8. Well, I guess this is probably a subterfuge book, right? Probably not gonna help us. Peep show, right? Oh, wait. I actually need to open the door first. Ash? What are you doing here, man? What?
Something I can do.
Yeah, let me check your stats here, since you are already here. Oh, he has appearance. Oh, he has seduction 10. That's insane. Has presence, celerity. Makes perfect sense. Charisma. The combat skills are not awesome, but range 7 with presence and celerity, he's very strong. And the seduction 10 thing is just insane. Good old Ash Rivers. So that's why she was bugged. She probably was the third wheel here. Alright, I'm going to use Ash. Talk about combat. Always fight hand to hand. Okay, so there you go, we have Ash. So I need to open a door there first, I think. Because I need a... There's a prostitute that is not on the stage right now.
What?
And we need her to move. So we need to open this one for her to be able to leave. Otherwise, she's going to get caught in the crossfire. Especially with this thing here. Okay. Okay, so let me re-equip my best armor here. Oh, she's actually not here. That's interesting. Okay, so we don't need to do anything, I guess. Oh, actually, we need to close the curtains. Oh. Behind.
What?
Behind. Hey, sir. Peep show. Here. Brrr. Peep. Show. Alright. Lockdown. There you go. Sorry guys, not today. I'm going to drink some water here real quick. Excuse me. Okay. Hopefully all of them won't be here anymore. I know where my guys are. Oh, there she is. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. I'll just go back into the pleasure palace.
Yes. That enthusiasm is infectious. Get behind me. Yeah, she got stuck here. What? Get behind you. Yeah, this cannot happen. I don't think. You know what? I'll try like this, but I think that's not a good idea. Oh, thank you. Thank you very much. Very kind. All right. Let's do it. Hey, Chastity. How are you doing?
Maybe I live, maybe I don't.
What? What's the difference? Oh, I see. I possess the guy, so I unequip my stuff. More using the best armor. Okay. Oh, so the gargoyle actually fought this time? Okay. Great. Kill the hunter with no loss of innocent life. Alright, it worked. 3. So I got 3 for not disobeying the quest. Alright. There you go, guys. So, turns out he can be helpful, but in the particular situation. You know what? I'm going to walk around with Ash a little bit. It was kind of an accident that she showed up here. But I knew he was companion, I just didn't know where he was. Here he is, so... He's fine, actually. Oh, I need to talk to him to start using ranged weapons now. Use ranged weapons. That's your what you're good at? I always felt like Ash could have been a better used character. We actually meet him twice, right? Because he's also stuck in the Society of Leopold. They capture him there. Not stuck, he was a captive there. Hey V.
Couldn't stay away.
About the hunter?
Mm.
Hunter's dead?
Mm.
Okay, there'll be others.
Yeah. Mm.
Snuff film?
No.
Nope. What's to do in Hollywood? I have to go.
Poor
Hatter, sure.
David, it was about.
About Kindred?
Yes. The detail.
Death?
Death.
So you want me to kill?
No.
Okay.
David, what?
Give it to me.
After this.
Sure. Okay. Yeah. It's a damn gargoyle teleporting here. So several mods add the dance, the private dance that she gives you after the second quest is complete. I don't know if this one does that. I hope not. It's not a YouTube friendly thing, really. But she's like dressed, as far as I remember. So it's fine. But after that, I think it's possible to give her the Animus.
Where to?
Okay. Santa Monica. So we need to get this... Wait. Oh, wait. No, that's a complete mistake. I'm sorry. Completely forgot about that. I need to go to the Lucky Star first. That was stupid.
Need a ride.
Yes. So that's why we were having so much trouble with Tourette not being able to stay in place, is because she was the extra follower in that situation. So she was not obeying my orders at all. Lucky Star is that side. The first part of the quest is not the Lucky Star, so now that we have all the quests here, we can finally do it. Oh, cats. I need to feed here real quick. You're perfect. Let's save, of course. Companions are crazy. Amos. Very interesting thing about the blood dolls in this game. The idea here is that you should either use your seduction or you should just straight up pay to have your way with a hooker here, and have your way in this situation is just like feeding on her. But the reality is they are all positioned in the hubs in such a way that they allow you to actually feed on them without doing anything. So I don't know. I don't think that was like by accident. I think that's how they designed the thing. So if you are smart enough, you don't need to pay a cent for any one of them.
Sorry, no vacancies.
Writers.
All right.
Me? A good writer? You do? I really can't talk about it. Okay, okay.
Julius, sure. There you go. The header quest is already done.
What?
Ash, wait. Gargoyle, wait. Okay. This is so crazy. Like, several episodes ago, we didn't have a single companion. Now we are walking around with freaking Ash Rivers and the Gargoyle. By the way, eventually we'll have to send Ash back because I don't think it's necessary for the Society of Leopold quest, but just like to avoid bugs, we should send back him back.
Something I can do.
We should use this option right here. Return to the place I found you. I'll come get you. You know? So that he can take part in that quest too, because he's actually important for that particular situation. Nah, he's not like important, that's like a strong word. He's like relevant. You notice him there right away, right? He reminds me of like the fact that all of the final quests in this game, most of like the final act of the game is completely rushed. So I always imagine if they had the resources and they could have like worked more on the game, there would be like way more like unique NPCs in those quests, but they became like just battlegrounds basically. Right, I think this is the one, right? Yeah, this is the one. Oh, okay. All right. So we have Brothers Salvage. Okay. So one of the quests for the serial killer is complete. Items? No. Alright. So let's try to open this. We have effective 9, I think. Yeah, so I think we can open this easily. I mean that because we have a very powerful blood buff here. So there's not many doors that I can't open anymore. Wallet, sure. What's the room that has the ring? Was the other one? I actually have to recheck that. Okay, nothing here. Some pills. Okay. What is this? Oh, the Heart of Darkness. Another one. We already got one of these. It's a weapon, right? Yeah. We cannot use it yet. 4 friend? I don't remember this. 4 friend. Really? What is this? Sam J. Sam J? Sorry? Oh, there's a dot. Sam J. Whoa, chill, what the fuck is going on? What is that? Oh my god. What the hell? Oh, I'm so not ready for this. The grease gun. Yeah. I think the only way is with ranged weapons. What do I need to do? I need to kill the guy? There's a guy right there? Well, isn't that something different? I have no idea. Never seen this before. Okay. So let's heal first. Oh, there's not an automatic weapon. Yeah, I need to kill them, probably. I was shooting the actual helicopter, but that's not the idea. Those are Society of Leopold guys, for sure. That's Bryan Danielson's theme song in WWE. And yeah, I'm very dead. Extremely dead. Okay. So now I know that's going to happen. So I actually need Ash here. The gargoyle is not going to help me here, but Ash will. Okay.
Something I can do.
Yes. Follow me. Oh, sorry.
What?
Come with me. There you go.
Sorry. No vacant.
We have to do this again. Vampire script.
A good ride.
Sure.
You do?
Man. Yes. Julius.
Okay.
There you go. So I apologize about that, but I have no. How would I know that, like, a helicopter with like the Valkyrie song is going to like show up here? That's a new one. Okay, well, these guys are very dangerous. They have an actual functioning helicopter. But if you guys remember, we already saw guys with a helicopter before in the. And yeah, I don't know what this dude is doing here. Maybe I didn't ask for him to wait this time around. We already met the guys with the helicopter in the mansion. The Malkavian mansion. Get behind me again. So before I click on the Sam J thing, stay here. Oh, I forgot. I need to use the blood buff here. Let me make sure I'm using the best armor. Okay. Nothing here. We have the wallet. Okay. The Heart of Darkness. We have some, yeah, drugs here. Okay. All right. So for a friend. So what happens if you never, what happens if you never interact with the PC? Console, awesome. Okay. So don't. Forget. So if you don't interact with this, if you are followed, that doesn't make any sense. All right, Sam J. So let's go, guys. Time to fight a war, I guess. The Gallery Noir, sure. Oh, it doesn't stop. Crazy. It's very unique. For all the wrong reasons. That's what I get for playing a melee character, huh? Really doesn't stop. That's a problem. Oh, I can switch to auto. Okay. That's good. Best we can do right now. guys are immortal? I don't think this guy can die, actually. Let's save here. Oh, I see. You guys noticed? Oh, I was going to talk, but it doesn't work. Oh, there you go, Jesus. Apocalypse. How do I say this word in English? Apocalypse, right? Apocalypse Now. There you go. Name of that movie. Thanks, Ash. You were very useful. So if you guys didn't notice what was going on there, he was shooting that super explosive, like, bazooka thing in the direction of Ash. And Ash was standing right here, so he was shooting inside his own aircraft instead of shooting towards us. So Ash saved the day here without hitting a single shot, just because he existed. That's one of those things in, like, basketball. You say that the gravity of a player makes the defenders, like, move towards him and opens up other players for them to shoot. That's basically what happened here. He just saved our ass. Apocalypse Now. I see. So do we have a new quest? No, but I need to go to the Gallery Noir. So let's go there before I forget. Enough is enough. Yeah. Oh, I forgot I need to do this one first before coming here. That was a mistake. VR rated rider. So yeah, we did not get a new quest here. Just some new stuff happened. Did they drop something? Oh, don't step on that. Sure. The pool's not gonna help. But man, that was one hell of an encounter, huh? A freaking... That's something I would never, like, even imagine. Well, I don't think V's gonna mind if I feed on him. The one thing that I can't do is hurt him. Not hurt him, kill him. So he should be fine. So let's just finish this up with the final part that we need to do here in the hotel. Then we'll start the next episode by going to the Gallery Noir. Man. That was so weird. But they really, really, really want to get me killed here. They even sent the freaking Air Force that they have.
The moon is a mistake. The lucky star moon.
Sure, I'll be there. Okay, there you go. Now I really like Ash Rivers. Now I'm really like, oh man, he really helped. So even if I don't keep walking around with the gargoyle, I'll probably keep Ash. Ash and Vivi is a good team. They are like brothers anyway. They already have that connection. So where's room 2? It's on the other side, right? Yeah. I never pay attention to the numbers here. Should be here. Yeah, the ring is here. There you go. Internet cafe key. Cannot open this. So whatever. Get behind. My man. That's the hero right there. Isn't it funny that the hero, the guy that saved the day, is actually an actor that used to save the day on the screen? What's the name of the... Negative Zero. Yeah, the great hero of the Negative Zero film. A classic. Ended up saving our ass here. So before I go, I'm just going to save in front of the Gallery Noir here. should not forget that I need to go there. But man, was today was a very eventful episode. I was not expecting this rally here. Come on, guys. Guys, in the manner of speaking. Alright. Garden War. Here we are, right? So, that's it, guys. So, in the next episode, we're going to find out what that's all about. And yeah, we finally have the gargoyle. We have good old Ash here. So, we'll keep proceeding with the quest here. And yeah, the whole Hollywood thing is very unfortunate. Well, the Romero thing. But hopefully that can be fixed somehow. So, that's it, guys. Thank you very much for watching. And I'll see you guys in the next episode.